Hi, this is going to be a tutorial on how to find any rogue applications or viruses that you have that are causing data overages. If you're with any cable companies or pretty much any internet provider, they normally have a data cap that you'll have depending on the speed. Currently, I have a 300 gigabyte per month data cap. That's quite a bit, but once we moved into our new house here, there's a few things going on, and we found that, well, we were easily exceeding that data cap. In one day, I had 70 gigs, and it took a couple weeks to find the culprit, and after the first month, you're going to get a warning letter from your internet company normally. So I'm going to go in and show you how to find these and how to monitor some things, depending on what kind of software you have on your computer. So the first thing you're going to want to do is run a virus scan and make sure there's nothing running in the background. I like to use malware, anti-malware bytes, or super antivirus. That's a good one also. There's a ton of virus programs that you can run to check for things. Just give that a shot first, see if that does anything. And with your internet providers, you can normally log into your account and see your data usage, so that's pretty easy. And it'll tell you how much you're using per day, or if you have a router that'll do that, you can also do it that way. So that'll be helpful also. So one of the things is run in, check your antivirus, see what's happening there. After that, the next thing you're going to do is check your task manager. I found the culprit to be SkyDrive or OneDrive, and I'm on Windows 8.1. So everything's integrated in, and there was no way to shut it off, but I had at least 20 gigs of files in there, and it was just constantly syncing at 20 megabytes per second, or megabits per second. But it was just ridiculous on how much usage it was using up. So if you open up your task manager, you can hit Alt Control Delete, go to task manager, or Control Shift Escape. That'll take you right to it. I have it pinned down here. But if you go here, there's going to be different categories. If you go to the processes, go across the top up here, it's going to tell you how much of everything you're using. And if you look at the fourth column, it's going to say network. And so that's how much bandwidth you're using. This is a good way to monitor any programs that are using a lot of bandwidth. I find that Outlook uses a little bit here and there, depending on, because I think it checks email if you actually use Microsoft Outlook. Other than that, you can just kind of scroll down. You can see when a little blip happens. But in my case, I found that the OneDrive was actually just constantly using 18 to 20 at all times. And it was pretty much all day, every day. So in all reality, it was just like going crazy. And you just saw like this number right here over in the network settings, just going to town on it. And it was just pouring through the data. And also, if you're using a mobile hotspot, this is a good way to check your bandwidth to make sure you're not going over. Because you don't want any data overages. I believe Comcast at one point, they might still has fines for every gig that you go over. And so that's a real issue. And they'll tell you to get a better class of internet. Your other option is to get business class, which gives you unlimited amounts. And the funny thing is, we have 50 megabits per second. If we ran that the whole entire time, it only takes about 17 hours. But I have to broaden that out across the whole month, so I don't know why they gave you such fast speeds when you can actually suck it up. If I was to download a 300 gig file, it would only take 17 hours if there were any complications. Just as an example. So that's going to be the first things you're going to want to check. If you can't do that, you're going to want to check your router. I also set some of my timeout settings for my router to shorter, so it dropped IP connections a lot faster. I believe that helped also. It also sped up my internet a little bit. And if you have any more questions, feel free to leave a comment below. I'm happy to help. Thanks. I hope this was helpful.